The topic in your syllabus is the use of hydrogen as the future fuel. The hydrogen can be used as an energy carrier that can transform our fossil fuel dependent economy into the hydrogen economy. It can be used as a primary fuel in internal combustion engines or fuel cells, producing virtually no greenhouse gas emissions when combusted with oxygen. A hydrogen internal combustion engine is similar to that of a gasoline engine, where the hydrogen combusts with oxygen in air and produces expanding hot gases that directly move the physical part of an engine. The only emissions are water vapor and insufficient significant amount of nitrous oxide. This, the hydrogen is considered as an alternative fuel of the future. The hydrogen can be used in traditional gasoline-powered internal combustion engines with minimal conversions. However, vehicles with polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cells provide a greater efficiency. In fuel cell vehicles, for example, 2009 Honda FCX Clarity, 1 kilogram of the fuel provides about 68 miles to travel. A polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cell produces an electrical current from the hydrogen fuel and oxygen in the air. At the anode, the hydrogen is split into hydrogen ions and electrons by the platinum catalyst. The PEM allows only the hydrogen ions to pass through the cathode, where these ions react with oxygen to produce water. The electrons travel down a circuit, creating an electric current. The fuel cells are arranged in stacks in order to provide enough electricity to power the vehicle. The use of fuel cell eliminates the nitrous oxide emissions. Furthermore, the fuel cell is this type of polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cell is 45 to 60% efficient. Now we have to discuss the different methods of production of hydrogen. Hydrogen, we know that hydrogen is the most abundant element on the earth. Although hydrogen does not exist freely in nature, it can be produced from several methods using a wide range of technologies. Some of these involve established industrial processes, while others are still at the laboratory stage. Some can be introduced immediately to help develop a hydrogen energy supply system, while the others need considerable research and development. However, only a couple of being environmentally beneficial. Among these, the first one is steam reforming of methane gas. Steam reforming of methane is currently used as the major route to hydrogen production. Here, the emissions involved can be controlled much more efficiently than our current system of transportation fuel. The steam reforming of methane process involves the methane gas is allowed to react with water vapor in presence of nickel catalyst at about 700 to 1100 degrees centigrade. That is, CH4 gas plus H2 gas gives CO2 gas plus 3H2O gas. The next reaction occurs at a lower temperature, that is, the carbon monoxide gas react with water gives carbon dioxide and hydrogen. The advantages of this method involves, first one is, it is a well understood process and it can be produced in large scale. The efficiency is about 65 to 75%, and this process is very economical, and this process is well established and it has well established infrastructures. The disadvantages, the small scale units for this processes are not commercialized. The hydrogen obtained in this case contain most of the cases containing impurities, and This is a non-renewable resource. Here also, in these processes result in the production of carbon dioxide emissions. Next one is the electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water is deemed to be the cleanest route to the production of hydrogen. However, the advantage of this proposed hydrogen economy is dependent on the use of clean renewable resources such as the source of electricity. Here, an electric current is passed through water that splits water into hydrogen and oxygen. That is, 2H2O liquid gives 2H2O gas plus O2. One of the advantages of this method is that it is commercially available process with the proven technology, and it is a well understood industrial processes, and it is a modular processes. This gives high purity hydrogen. The disadvantage of this method involves the use of the direct use of electricity. Next method is the gasification of coal. Gasification of coal involves the splitting of heavy hydrocarbons and biomass into hydrogen and other gases for the process of reforming. Then the reforming of the syngas that result in the mass production of hydrogen atom. At high temperature and high pressures, the coal is converted to syngas in presence of water vapor and oxygen. That is, coal is reacted with water vapor and oxygen gives syngas. The syngas undergo reforming to get hydrogen. Advantages: it is an inexpensive, it has inexpensive resources, that is, it is derived from coal, and it is a well understood for heavy hydrocarbons at a large scale. It can be used for solid and liquid fuels, and possible synergies with synthetic fuels from biomass gasification being demonstrated. Disadvantages: small units are very rare. Hydrogen usually requires extensive cleaning before use. Biomass gasification is still under research. Biomass land use implications are noted in this case, and here the competition with the synthetic fuels from biomass is involved. Another method is the solar hydrogen system. The solar hydrogen generating system can be provide a means of a totally emission-free method for producing hydrogen. In this process, hydrogen can be produced by the splitting of liquid water using the help of sunlight. That is, in presence of sunlight, the liquid water is converted to hydrogen and oxygen. Advantages involves here there is no emissions and it has 65% efficiency, and it is one of the disadvantages, it is very expensive. And the thermocycle processes are also used in the production of hydrogen gases, and also the biological production using algae and bacteria produce hydrogen directly in some conditions. Now we have to discuss the hydrogen storage and transport. The storage and transport of hydrogen is critical issue in hydrogen fuel industry because of the low density of hydrogen gas. Three possible solutions have been proposed to store the hydrogen. That is, we can store the hydrogen in the form of compressed gas, or it is in the form of liquid, or it is in the form of metal hydrate. And the advantages of the compressed gas involves the, it is reliable, it is indefinite storage time, and it is easy to use. And the advantages of liquid form of hydrogen is that it is high density at a low pressure. And the advantages of storing hydrogen in the form of metal hydrate involves it has high volume efficiencies, and it is easy to recover, and it is very safe. Currently, metal hydrates are used as the most promising hydrogen storage materials. Examples include palladium hydrate, lanthanum nickel hydrate, iron titanium hydrate, magnesium nickel hydrate, titanium vanadium hydrate, etc. The potential delivery systems of the hydrogen transport involves compressed tube trailers, liquid storage tank trucks, and compressed gas pipelines. References: solar fuels and artificial photosynthesis. Science and Innovation Change Our Future Energy Options, www.rc.org/solarfuels. Special Report: Hydrogen Energy and Fuel Cells, a Version of Our Future, European Commission Community.